comfortable going there. It's interesting to just kind of see how this will continue, you know, if we do this again. And
if.
There's no if.
No.
Well, you know, I didn't want to be the one to say.
No.
It's already in the atmosphere.
I was trying to make Michelle or Shaun say it, not me.
No.
I was trying to keep it suspenseful.
Well, the village has told us before we even got out of the room yesterday that, one, this can't be an annual thing. Like, we were told this cannot be annual. You have to do it more than once a year, because in all fairness to the girls, if you, or anyone, if you give them tools, there needs to be some type of follow-up. You need to check in with them or give them a platform in which they can check in or express, and we can see their progress or see where new challenges or opportunities had come up in their life, and then we can try to help them. So in that regard, so Shaun, talk about some of the tools you have in place, because we were social media bandits yesterday, right? Because that's where the youth is, right? So we have a website. What we were Snapchatting, we was Instagramming. Absolutely. So tell us how do we want to move forward with the ladies? Like, if they had something to say today, what should they do?
If they had something to say today, we actually want them to go. Yesterday I made sure to mention that they would be able to join a private. Now, this is private, so anyone who attended yesterday is the ones that would be involved in it. Not to say that I'm excluding anyone else, but what this was yesterday was an opportunity for them to open up, for them to put those vision boards together, and to be in a space that just was very intimate. Mm-hmm. So we want to keep that intimacy with them, but we also have some young ladies that I would like to protect the integrity of their Facebook and the integrity of anything that they discuss upon Facebook. So I know that even if you have a closed group that you can see the members. So what I have is a private Facebook for them, and that private Facebook will actually allow them to be in their Facebook group and talk about their wins, talk about their losses, vent about a bad day, but it is not a space that is negative. It's all positive. And the parents, as well as the speakers, have been invited to be in there. So the main thing for me is just making sure to keep anyone from that is not supposed to be there in there. But that is a space that when we have other events, and if there's more teens that join in, that then they join that group. That group is, it's like membership,
right?
You know what I'm saying? And it's a safe space. So it gives you, you know how you have an exclusive membership and only, you know, only that's like an American Express, right?
Yes,
American Express card holders have like some benefits.
Yes,
so we're treating our teen,
absolutely.
We're treating our teen girls empowerment attendees as very exclusive members. Okay. And so I do have the private Facebook page for them. Parents, you can make sure to reach out to me through an instant message or through the email. It's Shaun@teengirlsempowermentexpo.org. Or you can contact us through the website, which is www.teengirlsempowermentexpo.org. We are on Instagram as a group.
Yes.
As Teen Girls Empowerment Expo. And we are also have just a regular Teen Girls Empowerment Expo page on Facebook. So we have a few things out there, I think, to allow you to be able to reach out to us, contact us, and get engaged with our group.
Attallah?
Yes.
Yeah. You look like you had something. You look very intently. You know what? We're going to take a break right now. Right? We're going to take a break. And when we come back, we're going to talk more about the vibe, some of the feedback that we got. Because, again, we were on a, even though we won our separate spaces yesterday, I think we were still on a high. And a lot of, there was a lot of good comments and things that came back. And so I want to kind of talk about the vibe in the room yesterday and how special it was and things that we're going to do differently, right? So we'll talk about that when we come back. Thanks.
Yay. Thanks. Station in the world, playing all of today's hits. We're listening to Instinct Radio.
Real chicks rock.
Come
comedic, 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 comedic.
Unquestionable, the lover is professional. Got a category, my own, and I'm the president. Don't be alarmed, but I'm sewing up the resident. With my particular style, particular extracurricular, smoother and trickier. Throwing up lyrics like you throw up a flapjack. You ever chicken me nugget, and I'm a Big Mac. Brain smack, soloing, having Coca-Cola with. Doing very well, cause I took the right road to this. Road to this, make the undertaker, wreck the breaker. Get up on the floor, do the heavy D shaker. Started with the power, and I'ma end it with the bang. Bang, we got our own thing. My little, 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 little
understand this before you make a comment. There's always a meaning in a heavy D statement. In this life, I strive for improvement. Be your own God, follow your own movement. Love is a legend. Me, I'm legendary at it. Flipping on the mic makes me a rapping acrobat. Don't try to swing, cause you couldn't even hang. Hang. We got our own thing.
Today's hit.
We're
listening to Instinct Radio.
All right.
Hi, welcome back. We missed you guys. Listen, for those of you that are watching us on Facebook, we are not trying to be rude, but when we play music during the break, unfortunately, Facebook does not allow us to play the music. So we will stop airing every time we take a break for music, right? So, but if you want to keep up with us, feel free to always load the Instinct Radio app so that you can keep up with us all the time. So you can hear the music. You won't hear the conversation in the background, but you'll always hear the music. So when we left, we talked about the topic today is about the birth of Teen Girls Empowerment Expo. It happened yesterday in the wonderful city of Lithonia, Georgia.
January 14, 2017.
Yes, mark that down. It was a milestone date. That's east of Atlanta for those that are trying to figure out where that is. And so we were in it was in a grand ballroom. We took a couple of rooms, separated the wall. We had parents as well as daughters. The real cool thing about it is, and I don't typically shout people out, but I'm going to shout a few people out today. What was so really nice about it was the fact that there was a lot of familiar faces in the room, people that came through to support us. We want to thank everybody who made donations, people that knew they couldn't be there, but thought that the concept was worthy of them making some form of contribution. Trust me that your money went to good use, because we had over maybe anywhere between 20 to 25 girls yesterday.
Yes.
Shaun mentioned about Powerful Beginnings. I want to thank Monica, who sent her sister and then sent her daughter, her niece, and I think her goddaughter. So it's like one parent was coming with like maybe 2 to 3 girls,
right,
which made it really encouraging and very empowering. So yeah, the vibe was they didn't know what to expect when they walked in the room. They were a little nervous. They didn't know what it was. And I think that we wanted to make sure this isn't school, right? This is something that they can enjoy and understand and be free to express themselves. So we had to kind of do a couple of icebreakers just to kind of get people to get comfortable.
Yeah, it was Saturday morning. morning.
Yeah, it was Saturday morning, like 9 o'clock, true. You know. So people want to be home or doing what they do or getting their hair done. They don't want to be in some kind of expo for 4 hours that their mother is dragging them to. Yeah, so it was a lot on them. But it was really good in the sense that I felt that they were open. They were open. They were listening intently to what was being said. When Shaun shared with me that the types of speakers that she wanted, I felt that every person was going to walk away with something from somebody in that room. So even if I didn't reach everyone, Attallah was going to reach some people. Derrin was going to read somebody, and Dr. Smith was going to read somebody. So I think collectively, because I think the diversity in the panel was good, and the speakers
I
was good.
So too.
Yes, you know, so it covered you know, well, I hope so. I hope you agree. All right. So I think, you know, with that, we were able to penetrate and talk, and I think we were good in our space. Right. Yes. So Attallah is a huge proponent about designing your life, and that's really empowering what you want for your life. And the thing about the expo yesterday was, I think collectively we agreed, because we're older than the young ladies that were in the room. For some of us, significantly older. I'm raising my hand. significantly older than the women in the room. But I think we wanted to make sure that they didn't have to wait until they were our age to figure out what life was, right, and to make these decisions and choices. Like, they were empowered right now to make the choices that they needed to make. Right? I think we have a caller. Hi, caller. Thanks for calling.
Hello.
Yes, this is your man, Big Rich.
The Real Chicks That Rock. Hi, Rich.
I'm calling to check in on this wonderful expo. And let you know that us men of the cipher were praying for you all.
Oh,
and
awesome.
Hoping that you all had a great event. I hope it was wonderful and filled with knowledge and learning and all that good stuff. And let you know we still support you.
Well, thank you.
Awesome.
Thanks, Rich. It was. We thank you for the prayers, and we thank you for the support.
Absolutely.
And yes, it was. And Rich, hang on the phone for a second, because some of the vibes in the room was, this is really great, but are you going to do something for the men?
Absolutely.
So I don't know. We have not started the planning on that. I don't know, Shaun, if you wanted to say anything on that.
Well, I already told Big Rich, because actually we had a little conversation on this. Right, Big Rich?
That is correct.
Absolutely. So I spoke to the guys from the Cypher, and they actually asked me, you know, were fathers invited? Now, mm-hmm. we didn't see any fathers yesterday except for the father
in the room
of my daughter, mm-hmm. and my brother-in-law and things, the gentlemen who were actually at the event.
Well, I mean, I do know that there were fathers that reached out and said that they wanted to bring their daughters. Mm-hmm.
Awesome.
And so my assumption is that they definitely could have been there.
Yeah.
Okay. You know, because it was supposed to be about the girls.
Yes.
So I felt that would have been great to have seen fathers come, or, mm-hmm. you know, uncles or godparents who identify as men.
Yes.
You know, I thought that would have been great.
Mm-hmm. Well, we had a father, we had an uncle, we had a cousin.
Yeah.
we had some representation.
And we had men there supporting
Absolutely.
Us.
Absolutely.
That was awesome.
And brothers. I'm sorry. Yeah. I don't want to discount my own sons. So just make sure that
awesome.
I shout that out before they're looking at this event. And then I get back home and they're calling me by my nickname.
I'm so glad to hear you all saying that part of it. And that's another reason why I called in today, because I wanted to sort of say to your listeners that, again, just piggybacking on the greatness of what you all are doing, but also just it's never too many times where you can remind our men of all ages about protecting our princesses, protecting our little girls that are out there, and also reminding them that as men that protect our daughters, our nieces, our granddaughters, they understand how to be ladies to men as they grow up and get older. And so I just really think that's important. And I like Shaun said, we talked about that. Michelle and I talked about that. The other beautifully, classically beautiful young lady that's sitting in the room, maybe one day you and I will talk about
all
that.
All right,
absolutely.
But I just think it's really it's so important.
All right. Thanks, Rich. One other thing before you go. We were also talking about not only men being there for their daughters, but there was talks about us doing this for young men.
Yes.
Right. That, we have it already in place. So just, I would say what you want to do is reach out to us because it's coming. We have about...
Yeah, it's been 24 hours since the expo ended. You know, it's only been 24 hours. But yes
to whom much is given. Even in the place of fixing the one for the girls, we already had... It's written in my papers, on my notebook. Let's make sure we do one for the boys. And I think my first post actually said, okay, yes. And just know that there will be one for the boys. Yes. So I'm not going to spearhead that. I'm going to let the man of the house spearhead that because
men need to do that right for the boys.
Men need to do that for boys. Yes. I don't want to put a female or feminine spin on it. And that's no aspersions on casting, no aspersions on anyone. But I just feel like a man can help a man be what he needs to be. And regardless of where you are in your life and things, I think that support is very important. Mm-hmm. Don't get me wrong. I still will be there. I will still be 100% within the fabric of the manifestation mm-hmm. of it. But mm-hmm. it definitely just keep in touch with us, Rich. You know, you already are family. So we're there.
Absolutely. Most definitely we'll keep in touch. I'm excited about what you all are doing. I'm excited at the prospect of being able to help out in any way. And I'll even be so bold as to take this opportunity and put a challenge out there to all of the men that are listening to this broadcast.
Come on.
Listen to future broadcasts. to contact these organizations. Contact Shaun. Contact Michelle. Contact anyone that's involved and say, hey, what can you do to help make this thing better and as it expands? And then that's just another branch of young people that we can reach out to and put protection over and give knowledge to. So I'll be so bold as to send that challenge out right now.
All right.
You know, whenever we're ready,
put it in the atmosphere.
Let's get it.
Thanks, Rich. We'll take that. Thank you, Rich. We appreciate you always, always, always.
Absolutely. Much love to you all. Y'all have a great day, all right?
Thank you.
Bye,
you
Rich.
Too.
Peace. Thank you.
So in talking about the vibe in the room, let's talk about the vision board. Why a vision board? Why is that so hot these days? Oh, go.
Well,
I
was just gonna say it was so interesting. I was gonna say it was so interesting because I was invited to a vision board party yesterday.
Really?
Right. So it's like, you know, it's the beginning of the year, and you know, you just want to get yourself together. Mm-hmm. And there's been studies that have shown that if you see things, if you consistently see things on a daily basis, if you put things on paper, that they will actualize, mm-hmm. factualize. And they will come to fruition. More, it's more than likely that will happen. So, I mean, I know the vision board party idea it seems to be very popular, mm-hmm. but I thought it was great to do it with young women, right. with young girls. And someone asked yesterday about the boys, about men, and if, you know, would they want to do that? And I think men need to do hands-on things. Mm-hmm. They need to do things like that, touching art and feeling. And that's the whole thing for me that the vision board, that's great about the vision board. It's the whole interaction,
right.
touching things,
right.
you know, really just having more of a connection to the words that you're cutting out and thinking about instead of maybe just typing things on mm-hmm. a phone, mm-hmm. you know, mm-hmm. or clicking like, you know, we see inspirational quotes all the time, like, or, you know, we see memes. You know, we're like, yep, I agree with that. Mm-hmm. But to really start, you know, putting things up in your home and mm-hmm. things that you know you want to see. So hopefully what these girls are doing is they brought those posters home mm-hmm. and it's going to be somewhere,
yes.
you know, on their wall, in their room, something that they can see every day. And it was really, to me, it was great to see some of the pictures that they chose. Mm-hmm. And it was just phenomenal.
It was good.
It was phenomenal.
I agree. I saw all of the vision boards, and I took a picture of my own daughters. I didn't get a chance to get a picture of my nieces because it went in the car with mom. But I saw just the 10-year-old. I don't know if anybody else. We did have a 10-year-old, and I was okay with that as long as the mom was okay
right.
with that. My goal is to reach the 13 to 18-year-olds. However... we had three young ladies there yesterday, representation from what, 9, 10, maybe 10 and 11.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Four, excuse me, because we did have another 11-year-old.
Right.
And these girls were very, I have to say the maturity level was there because they were focused, they were engaged, and their vision boards, just what their vision is for them was, I was blown away.
Right.
I should have took a picture of hers because when I looked at it, it was full. But it was her words. Like, I told them, if the magazines don't get you, I've got blank paper here.
Right.
Use that Sharpie. Write what you want to say on there. Now, I don't remember everything that is said on there, but it was like a believe in yourself and don't worry about everybody else kind of thing. And I was like, whoa, I love it. And I'm just saying the vision board is just what Attallah said. It's a thing that everybody's doing right now. But again, remember what I said before, when I felt like it's always being done for the entrepreneur or for an adult, and we don't see it being done. And I'm not saying that any parent is not doing it for their family, because I know we do resolutions at the beginning of the year, like, okay, what do you want to do? What is it that we could support you in? How are you trying to, what goals are you trying to reach this year that we as parents can make sure you reach? But when you're saying it, like you said, seeing something, I think makes a greater impact on you, because like you look at your wall and you have all your great artwork on there, and that thing gives you a feeling.
It does.
You know what I'm saying? I have a couple of art pieces on my wall. One is like three women. It's a grandmother embracing the mother, embracing the granddaughter. And then I have one where it's the father embracing the son, embracing his son. And it's like, when you can see it, the emotion that you get makes you like that much more propelled to say, I am focusing in on this. And that vision I see, like, you know how people say have tunnel vision because at the end of the tunnel is that light. And that's why I think that the vision board is so important. I just can't see not having it. I'm so that person that needs it on my phone that give me a notification. Did I reach my goal today? You know, check in at the end of the week. I'm the Sunday planner, checking my to-do list. So if I'm doing that for me, that vision board piece for the girls, I thought was so key.
I mean, they jumped right into it. As soon as I put the magazines down, they started going through the magazines. And they weren't distractive about it. They just grabbed a book and they started looking. And then there was an energy like, oh, because they felt like I need another pair of scissors, like, because we didn't have enough scissors for everybody. So then
a second set of scissors out the door.
People felt like, oh man, I gotta wait till I cut this up. But I saw them like dog earing the pages and ripping them out in preparation for when they got what they needed. They can go ahead and just start doing it. So everybody walked out of there with a board. And which was really great. That was the exciting part. And the timing of it was good, because at that time we had spent a couple of hours throughout the day. So they had known one another, got to know one another, or heard questions, like Attallah was saying. Then once they had lunch together, they got to socialize a little bit. And so they was ready to get in. So when Derrin came in to talk about gymnastics, I think it was, the timing was just really great, because they were really ready for you. They were ready for you. Real quickly, Derrin, tell us what was the vibe when you walked in? How did you feel the girls were responding to your questions and things?
It's okay. I definitely felt like they were ready. I definitely felt like they were already in a positive space, and that they wanted to work on what, like, their dreams, which was a part of what I talked about that day.
I really felt like once Derrin did her opening key piece where she said, okay, I'm giving you guys, what was it, 3 minutes?
Yeah.
Yes. I'm giving you 3 minutes to introduce yourselves to each other. Now, we had did that icebreaker in the beginning, but I think that you doing it that way, that was like great because it made sure that each girl took the time to like really see the other person that was there because they were nervous. Some of them were like, okay, I don't know you and I don't know anything about you. And how do I like relate? How do we start to get to interact a little bit differently here if I don't know you? And I thought that Derrin doing that was like phenomenal because as soon as she did it, they were like, okay. And not only did she engage the girls, I think the parents did the same thing. So we had the parents introducing themselves, learning a little bit about one another. Mm-hmm. And it was, I thought it was great. And I thank Derrin for that because that broke even more of the ice. Mm-hmm. And when those vision boards and things like they just start working more in tandem, I think at that point, it just brought everything that we had been doing all day right in place.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. It was really good. I think there was a lot of excitement in the gifts as well. People were really excited to get the STEM gifts. And not only because of the Hidden Figures movie that's out, but just that, girls are typically not involved or considered to be part of IT or technology or mathematicians or engineers or scientists. And so to see a young lady there, young, and inspired and really wanting to donate her time to help other young ladies get on board was awesome. The bags that she gave them with materials, I think it was math and science stuff inside. I mean, people were just really excited about the things that they got, what they walked away with, the experiences. Just the energy in the room throughout the day was just really good. They really appreciated Attallah. Attallah has a way to relate to young people. I think you teach young ladies how to model, that keeps you definitely in tune. And so your whole platform about Design Your Life was, I think it was definitely something that they needed. They really received it. And there was a proudness when we talked about the art of head wrapping and the fact that you do that. I saw, bodies sit astute in the chair like, yes, that's something that we have. That's something that we can own as young women of color. Some piece of feedback that I heard was, and that's just us, and we're going to apologize to pardon our own ignorance. We typically fall into a category where we say we have to do these things because we're black women or this, that, and the third. And we have to understand that in this world, there's more diversity, and the diversity isn't always visible to our eyes. So I say that to say that there were young ladies in the room that were multiracial. They were biracial.
Yes.
So there might have been an energy or a slight offense that we were, some of the comments or the tone was geared to just black girls or black women in general. Yeah, so that's a takeaway. And just understanding that even though everyone may appear to have a melanin that looks familiar, we can't take for granted or assume that they are, I don't want to say a single race because that's not the proper term, but we can't assume that they are have a black mother and father. There is diversity that we just can't see. So that's a takeaway point, and that's for anybody that's listening. Just be mindful that when you're interacting with people, again, the times are changing. And so you're going to have people that are not coming from the same environments that you might be exposed to. There is diversity in their home, and so they may lean more to one culture than the other. So we have to be mindful of that. I'm showing you shaking your head. Would you agree or no?
I do agree. I'm sorry. I was really focused in, and I was in agreement with you on that because I feel that we have to be careful of how we categorize that. I think a lot of times what happens is we continue to push that what would you say a stigmatism onto that being black. But I think that at the same time we have to make sure we do embrace that format, that thought pattern, because some people are not happy being Black. Mm-hmm. And some people are willing to remove themselves from mm-hmm. that heritage mm-hmm. of what you have. And I don't think that it's anything that's demeaning to you if you embrace who you are, right. regardless of what that is.
Right.
I loved the head wrap session, and I thought that everyone who sat down just—I mean, I usually throw my locks up. You know, mm-hmm. you've seen me do my head wrap on my head. I didn't necessarily. Mm-hmm. Oh, you never.
No. I was thinking about the way that yesterday went. That's all.
Oh, okay. Yeah, and I loved every. I mean, they were sitting in the chair. Attallah's pulling people's hair together, and it's instant. Like, she has a phenomenal gift for mm-hmm. that. And I think, again, like you said, it's just, you know, you just have to be able to embrace who you are. Right. And I think that was also part of the vision, just to define your identity is not one thing.
Right.
It is about so many different key pieces that equal mm-hmm. the identity. Right. I mean, like 1 + 1 = 2, but you start putting 2 + 2 = 4. There's so much stuff that equals
mm-hmm. a whole.
Right, the whole. Mm-hmm. And so you have to be just ready. And I think that's my goal with this was just let's ready them.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you're not going to get everyone ready.
No.
And then even when you have them ready, you still have to keep making them ready.
Right. It doesn't
I'm a business
away.
Person. I still have to keep getting ready. You know what I'm saying? I still have to keep putting that. Let me remember to make sure I'm doing what I'm supposed to do. As a mom, it's like, let me remember to continue to do what I'm doing. And don't get it twisted. As moms and women, we are still looking in the mirror and saying, oh, it's a bad hair day. We are not saying that we are perfect, but we want to make sure we tell you that, you know what? You don't have to be perfect to make sure that you remain yourself.
Right. Your work in progress. Go ahead, Attallah.
Yeah, I think that the key word yesterday was empowerment. I think yes. that's what the key word yesterday was. And so I think, and I hope, because one of my goals and the thing that I try to do in my life is try to get women and try to get girls to recognize their layers.
Yes.
So I'm listening to you talking about ethnicities and yes. backgrounds, and the doctor, Dr. Dominique Smith, she shared that her family was from Haiti.
Yes.
My family is from Panama and Costa
yes.
Rica.
Yes.
You know, and I definitely shared with the girls that head wrapping, that's international.
Yes.
That's something indigenous people mm-hmm. do. That's something that people in Asia do. That's mm-hmm. something that people all throughout the continent do for different reasons, mm-hmm. for religious reasons, for cultural reasons, for fashion, and for what I like to call days that are not as good as other days in terms of our hair.
Right.
I don't use the term bad hair days. So anyway, I just wanted yesterday to be a day where girls hopefully recognize their layers. And that's why I thought that having the different speakers was really great.
Yes.
For them to see the different variations of what women of color are.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that we really are colorful and that all of us are so different.
Yes.
But hopefully they could see themselves in other people and other people besides maybe what they see in the mainstream.
Yes.
And that there's real life women that's out here working and doing wonderful things. So that's why I thought it was great. I thought it was great. I thought it was very colorful.
It was.
I thought it was colorful. The rainbow represented.
Yeah, it was. Did you want to say?
Yes.
I heard a little bit of it because Coop's making a lot of noise. But as far as the diversity piece, I think it's important that Black women speak to Black women regardless in a space. So even if there is a white child, like completely white, from our sight, because we don't know, like
mm-hmm,
you were saying,
mm-hmm.
I still feel like if as a Black woman, I should speak to the Black children.
Mm-hmm.
At some point, as I'm speaking, I should definitely include everybody.
Mm-hmm.
But because of our history and because of what our Black girls have dealt with, our brown girls have dealt with, I like to say, I just think it's important that we actually speak to them
mm-hmm.
In a forum like this. So that was it.
Yeah. Yeah.
Makes sense.
Definitely.
So somebody's been asking, we're getting a lot of questions about what next, and I don't want to jump to that right now, but we're definitely looking to take it on the road, right? So someone is asking, I think, on the thread. Thank you, audience members that are telling us what's going on. We got a lot of beautiful people in the room today with us in the studio, so we're thankful for that. Asking us, are we going to go national with this? And the answer is yes. We are definitely going to go national on this. Yes. We have already started to have conversations about our next city. That will be a surprise. We're not telling you yet. You have to be a part of the interworkings of the family to understand what that, to understand what that is. And we'll let you know when we're ready, because we got to get dates and schedules and things of that nature. But yes, I had spoke to Shaun and said before we had launched this that this would be a 5-city tour for us this year. So it's already January. We've done Atlanta. And so we're going to do... we're going to do another city soon. So we're on our way. We're on the road. So with that, I'm going to take a break. And like I said, when we take these breaks, we cut off on Facebook. Yes, we leave Facebook. But if you have the InstinctRadio.net app, you can continue to hear the music. The music's provided by our DJ, DJ Kometic. So go ahead and listen to that. And we will be back in a few minutes. Thanks.
Real chicks rock. Comedic, 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 com listening to Instinct Radio.
Hi, welcome back. We don't deserve a break because we clown. We just do all kinds of stuff. And for the record, Attallah, this is her fourth time.
Yeah, I'm a Real Chicks Rock Radio alumni. Is that what you would call me?
This is your fourth time. I can't help it. I have good topics that I feel you should be a part of. That's what it is. So thank you.
Thank you for always having me
back. Oh, Attallah, I love you. Thank you so much. So listen, we wanted to come back in. Hi, Cooper.
Hi.
He was. At the record show, he was fine. No break. Your staff wanted to talk to you. So we were good. We were talking about when we left the vibe in the room. So how do we keep that energy going for the girls? Now, we talked about the website. And we talked about them being able to post in the social media platforms. Is there anything else that we can do? What is our plan of attack to make sure that all of those young ladies that were there can have access, or that we can infuse the right nutrients to them, if you will?
Huh? Okay, go ahead, Shaun. Go ahead, Shaun.
we're both ready. But what I wanted to do was I wanted to make sure that we, as the individuals that were involved in it, that mm-hmm. we are still like posting things. If Attallah has a head wrap session or she's doing something somewhere, what I want you all to be able to do and to do, mm-hmm. This is what you say, your challenge or your shout out to mm-hmm. do, to put things out that you're going to be involved in that those girls would want to be involved mm-hmm. in. They've already had like a moment to see what Attallah does. They have right. a moment to see what Derrin is doing, as mm-hmm. well as Dr. Smith and yourself. Mm-hmm. And I think as long as you keep putting information out there,
okay.
That they will be able to have that impact. And I also want to meet up with the girls like every 3 months. Mm-hmm. I've been involved in Habitats for Humanities, mm-hmm. and it's been like a women's build. So it's all women building that mm-hmm. house for individuals who are looking for housing. Mm-hmm. And I love the idea of Habitat for Humanity. And that would be a great thing that I think that all of us could kind of do and have fun. We learn, I mean, because mm-hmm. what that does is, you know, you don't have to have a handyman.
Right.
You know what I mean? You are your handyman mm-hmm. because you're learning a tool and a trade for yourself. When you own your house, when you have your apartment, then you know how, I mean, me and my mom learned how to put in windows.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? I learned how to put in doorknobs and right. put up a door and just all different things that we did just in building that home. I think something like that would empower the young ladies. And just little, you know, you kind of get back into doing little things where we just meet back up. Like I said, I don't want it to be that we just meet the once a year, but I think the once a year is important because let's start 2018 outright.
Right.
Let's still do the expo that pushes you to move throughout your year, mm-hmm. but throughout your year, don't lose that impact by, okay, they got it.
Okay.
Now and y'all, you know, we hanging in the wind. We like a flag, you know.
And that's
it's
it.
Like, okay, what happened?
Right.
No, what you want is you want to still have those key pieces and those key faces that they kind of came in contact and they connected to
yes.
that you still are putting something out there for them to do. I mean, I even like what we do with the breast cancer walks. You know, get out there, let's put our tutus on and represent. You know what I'm saying? Let's just do different things. It doesn't all have to be community service. So it doesn't right. always have to be that. It can be, we go to a ballet, we go to I'm sorry, I'm into the strings. So I do have sons right, and daughters right. who are in the, you know, in the music and things yes. like that. And so, you know, you might not necessarily think you want to play a violin, but what if you want to play a violin?
Yeah.
You
yeah.
know, what if you want to play a cello?
I'm a violinist. Don't look this
okay.
way.
Okay.
yeah.
But I didn't know that.
I know.
Yeah. Yeah. My son plays the cello.
Okay.
My daughter is the violin. My son's playing the trumpet. And, you know, we just have people that do different things. And I just feel like we don't know if any of the girls, I don't think anybody mentioned yesterday whether they played an instrument. I don't think we went
the musical way.
Right.
No.
I think we just asked to like give two things. I think Derrin, that's what you said, right? Actually put two things that we could quickly get within 3 minutes. But
right.
I think if we just continue to meet up, because I feel like we have made a connection, and that's
right.
just my That's just my thoughts. And so I'm sorry, Attallah, I took it.
No, go.
No, no. I was going to say something. There was something yesterday that I wanted to put out there. So I model and I'm also a model and runway coach. And so with the things that I do, there's definitely times where I'll do a model call and I'll need models, you know, so I want the girls to be able to reach out to me for those reasons. Mm-hmm. Also, I'm looking for young people who might be interested in interning, who are interested in doing social media. I need someone to do social media for me.
Right.
You know, and I have a mentee. She's 17 years old. She mm-hmm. goes to Lithonia High School. Mm-hmm. And I think there were two girls yesterday that went to Lithonia right. High School.
Yes.
So, I mean, there's a lot, you know, and I also made an announcement, or I said yesterday, that if anybody felt like if they wanted to inbox me, mm-hmm. like you can inbox me, you can reach me, you can direct message me. Those are the kind of inboxes and direct messages that I would prefer to get.
Right.
You know, where someone is saying, this is something that I would like to do, or this is something that I need help with. And so I put myself out there and saying that if any of the girls need help, you know, I also do child sexual abuse prevention. So if there's anything that you're going through that you're struggling with, where you feel like you're trying to figure out, who can I tell this to? There's something that may be uncomfortable for you to speak about. Hopefully your teachers and your family members are there, but let's just be real. There's some things sometimes where you're just like, I don't know who to tell.
Right.
So I want the girls hopefully to also use the Facebook page as a resource of people in the community who can really be there for them. Mm-hmm. In different ways, because being a teenager, I remember, and so Michelle, you were talking about me as far as connecting with the girls. I'm not a parent,
right?
So a lot of times when I look at young people, when I look at children, I remember and I see myself.
Mm-hmm.
I see myself and I say, you know what? Because I'm not coming from a parent's perspective, and I say, I remember, I needed that.
Mm-hmm.
I remember. I had this, and then I remember I didn't have this.
Right.
So that's really what we want for the girls. We want them to be empowered to help themselves.
Right.
We want them to also be empowered to ask for help. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, definitely reach out to me online. There's a lot of stuff to do.
Yes,
there's a lot of stuff to do. You know, girls ask me about, you know, what it means to be a wardrobe stylist. Like, I'm here, and I think we all bring so much to the table. Where I can definitely say we'll be around. We'll be here.
There was unfortunately there was only one young lady. She just did not want to be there. And I greeted her from in the hallway. She just didn't want to be there. And her mother made her come. Her mother was very engaged in the fact that she brought her there on time. They stayed till the very end. And she felt that her daughter needed to be there. And the energy was, the young lady was very quiet, but her energy was really strong in the sense that people picked up on her not wanting to be there.
Yes.
And they went and they talked to her and sat with her. I had some young ladies kind of share the table with her because she was going to sit at that table by herself. No, you're not. And so people were trying to engage with her. And I think something broke inside of her. Like, she really let some of those barriers go. But just out of the fact of, I'm going to still kind of stay stubborn. I don't want you guys to think that this really helped me.
Right.
You know, that was still her fragrance when she left the room. So I think that we touched everybody in there, whether they liked it or not. Because
at first.
Yeah, because
it warmed up.
It warmed up because the presentation was inviting, mm-hmm. and it was infectious, and it was done with very good intent. And so you had to, with those elements, you have to kind of like, you give up, you know, because we're going to wear you down with positive energy. So you're gonna give up and say, okay, all right, I'll do the board. I'll do whatever you want me to do. Okay, yes, I need this.
But also, let me just interject there too, because when I had the conversation with her, I wasn't going to bring her up because I was, you know, just trying to leave her, you know, like let her lay and let her be okay. But her whole thing that she mentioned to me, and I said, you know, are you enjoying it? Are you having fun? She mm-hmm. said, yeah, I'm enjoying it, but you know, I don't really need it.
Mm-hmm.
And so what I want to say about
that's profound.
Yes. Mm-hmm. What I wanted to say to everyone is that you may not necessarily need what everyone else needs, but what you have as a, like I said before about the strength and weaknesses, her strength could empower someone who wants to be what you're trying to be. You, like, she had the elements of success in my eyesight.
Mm-hmm. Right. That, and she probably has the element of leadership.
Yes.
Right. And so she could be, if you know, now that we're talking about it, she could be like a teen that comes on and she be the person that kind of speaks on their behalf. Like a liaison.
Yes.
You know what I mean?
And that's.
Yeah. So, I mean, you know, there's, like we said yesterday, everybody has a purpose.
Right.
Yes. You know, and I remember saying yesterday, some people are introverts. Some people are extroverts. Mm-hmm. You know, some people don't want you coming over to them, asking them how they're doing, sitting next to them, getting in their face. Some people don't like that. There's some of us are adults. We prefer to spend time alone. Mm-hmm. Some people prefer to spend time with people that they know. And mm-hmm. some people are at home with everyone. Mm-hmm. And so I think we had all of those kinds of girls right. there yesterday. So I think it was great that she was there. I think it was great that she was there. Yeah.
Because I don't know how much she spoke to the girls next to her, but I don't think she was silent the whole time.
Okay.
And even if she was a little silent, like I said, she said, you know, these are some of the topics and things that I talk about with my mom. And the reason why I brought these topics and things to place is because as a mom, I've had these conversations with my daughter too. Mm-hmm. But it to me, it kind of brings home that, okay, what your mom is telling you is important, and right. that some other moms think the same thing. Not that we're trying to beat anyone over the head, because that's not where I want anybody to ever think that this whole expo is coming from. It's not coming from a place of you need to be mm-hmm. this individual mm-hmm. and that is it.
Right.
It's about being your own being individual. Who you are.
Right.
Yes.
Being
and, who you are. And allowing you in this space to do that. Mm-hmm. And to include your parents, because parents, we're not perfect, but we're here trying to give you what we think you need to be that best person. Right. And as a woman, we can relate to what you are experiencing. Now, you can say all day long that you're not experiencing some things, but I picked up
on energy in the room.
Okay, we've all been teens.
Ooh, yes.
So we've experienced being a teenager. And yes. I know sometimes I think that there's that disconnect, like, okay, you're old and you don't remember, but I think that
we're not old.
Okay. Yeah. But being...
I'm not old.
Okay.
Don't look over here.
I'm getting ready to try. Shoot, I'm the 20-year-old.
You see me? I was like,
I said,
let me get Michelle to say something.
Absolutely. Yeah. Okay. But what I'm, you know, I just... That's kind of where I went in drawing the conversation with the young lady. Because again, like you said, that leads to leadership. That mm-hmm. Don't just sit here. What you have, like, give it. Like, share it. And be okay with, like, disconnecting, like, mom, you got on my nerve before I got here, okay, or whatever
that
vibration mm-hmm. is. So, mom, we don't want you to think that was
isn't
what
that
the
teenage
vibration
angst?
Was.
That
absolutely.
Is teenage angst.
That's
absolutely.
What I wonder. I'm like, is that
so, mom, we
angst?
Were very appreciative that you were there yes. with your daughter. I actually appreciated your daughter being there because, you know what, we didn't want to have a perfect setting, but we right. wanted to have a successful, impactful, insightful event that each individual person brought something to the table. And I think that shook up the room.
Yes, it did.
Yes,
it did. Like, you know, shout out to Shaun Macaulay Stewart.
Yes.
She brought her daughter,
yes.
Mesa.
Shaun, what was it? Shaun Square?
Shaun. Yeah.
Yes.
I mean, it was, you know, it was great. And there were just all different kinds of girls. Everybody doesn't do black flips in order to show, you know, how good something is. Some people are just a little bit more inner with the way that they show what's going on.
And with that, I want to say this. Phyllis Robinson is a huge, in my mind, a huge community service activist, and she's an artist. And every time I seem to do something, she shows up to support it. So she was kind enough to bring me this gift that she, I believe she drew this, she painted this yesterday, and it looks like two girls that are together. And I just want to thank Phyllis Robinson for that gift. Empowering women, coming in there, just being on fire, networking with people. On the back it says, dream big. In 20, you will get there in 2017. So thank you, Phyllis, for that. I don't typically do shout outs like that, but I felt this was so appropriate, and we're going to keep this with us every time we do the Teen Girls Empowerment Expo, which, like I said, we're taking it on the road. We're going to do 5 cities this year, and we just want to thank everybody. Yeah, it's already done. We just have to show up and do the work and do the concepts and all that kind of stuff. And so another thing that was shared with us, and I'm going to wrap this up soon, another thing that was shared with us is that if we continue to do it in Atlanta this year, that the theme will be different. So we've been looking at changing the theme because the foundation has been set yesterday. We set a precedent yesterday as it relates to defining your identity. So for that, we are very thankful. We want to thank everybody that shared it, told people about it. Again, the donations, everything. It would have not been a success if you guys did not participate and join. Yes,
thanks for sharing the
and
post.
So it was wonderful, awesome. And the videos and all of that content that was going on. Before I get out of here, I always want to allow my guests an opportunity to just tell us what's going on with you and how people can find you. So Attallah, tell the people.
So you can find me online. My real name is Attallah Pamoja, Pamoja. And you can find me on social media at Design Hour, LIVES. And I'll be doing my first, for the year, my first child sexual abuse prevention training with an organization. And I'm just looking forward to doing more of those as the year continues. I'm really excited that people want to do this at the beginning of the year. Just get it, you know, just really get it on. And that's for adults so that we can protect and prevent the abuse of children.
Awesome.
So, yeah, thank you.
Thanks, Attallah. Shaun.
All right, well, you can reach me at Shaun@teengirlsempowermentexpo.org. You can also find out more about me on my own website, because I do have my own business. Again, my business is Nuwas LLC. So if you spell Shaun backwards with LLC, you'll find me there. You can find me on Instagram. You can find me on Twitter, Facebook, everywhere, right. LinkedIn and all of those social media places. But definitely I look forward to seeing some people's emails come in about this. And Derrin has stepped away, but I do have Derrin's information. So Derrin Moore is the coach and owner of In-Flight Gymnastics, and you can reach her at www.inflightgymnastics.com. She's on Twitter at InFlightGym. So that's spelled GYMN, and then Instagram at InFlight Gym. You could also reach her on Facebook at InFlight Gym. So there you go.
Right. Well, for those of you,
And Dr. Smith is actually at Premier Women's Healthcare.
Okay.
And Aesthetics.
You
so
see me
just,
on the edge of my seat?
I'm sorry. I forgot. All right.
Come on. I got my time. So listen, for those of you that attended or wanted to still support, et cetera, could not be there. Listen, I'm in the t-shirt business. We got the t-shirts. Right. We looked really great in them. They come in 2 colors, orange and black. Shaun, how can I get the t-shirts?
All right, so the t-shirts will be up on our website today. You will be able to get them for $15 plus $5 of shipping and handling. So that's going to be on our website, and we have our Attallah modeling that shirt for you. Again, that's in in black and white, black and orange, excuse me. So you'll be able to see that information up on our website, teengirlsempowermentexpo.org.
All right. Well, I want to thank our guests today. It's always fun. I think sometimes I get a little silly because I feel like I know you guys. Some are regulars. I can't do what I do without my... Shaun is my executive assistant for RCR. Yeah, she gets promoted every time she does things for me. I love her to death, and I'm glad that she was here and this whole vision came to pass. And we're going to continue to do more great things and empower the masses. If you want to get me, I am Michelle Dawes Burt. That is me. I am at realchicksrock.com. I got Real Chicks Rock, the fan page. I'm on Instagram. I'm on Twitter, Real Chicks Rock 1. So if you want to get at me, and we have on YouTube the Real Chicks Rock channel. So for those of you that can't listen to us when we're broadcasting it live, we're sorry, but we have snippets of the show that you can check out, all the previous content. You could go see Attallah. She's been with, this is number 4, so you can see on the previous shows that lies out there on the YouTube channel for Real Chicks Rock. We thank you for everything, all your support. We cannot do this without you. Until next time, we ask you, continue to rock on. Bye.
Thank you. Peace.
Station in the world playing all of today's hits. We're listening to Instinct Radio.